Okay, next we have Sonia Limaye from Hofstra University.
Yes.
Continuing to talk about American shad.
Nope.
Dang.
Alewife.
switch now to Alewife.
Hi, my name is Sonia, and today I'm going to be discussing our research looking at the release of translocated Pitek alewives into a Long Island lake to measure the efficacy of a new fishway. So I'm sure as you guys all know, there's a few different ways that you can measure the efficacy of a new fishway. You can place an underwater camera within the entrance or exit pool of your fishway to detect fish as they enter or pass through the structure. You can also tag and release fish as they return back to your study site to spawn every year. You can use electronic tags such as a pin tag and construct an antenna to detect them as they pass through the fishway. You can also tag them with physical tags and then recapture them at a later point within your study site. These techniques are relatively easy to do when you have fish returning back to your study site. However, this wasn't the case for us at our lake. There have only been scarce observations of alewives below the spillway during past spawning runs, so we don't really have a predictable run returning back to Beaver Lake every year. So our big question was, how are we going to monitor the efficacy of this new fishway if we don't have fish returning every year? So we decided to use translocated alewives at our lake to initiate a spawning run there and to monitor the efficacy of the new fishway. So fish passage across Long Island has basically been obstructed in every major freshwater lake and river due to the construction of dams and culverts. So this map represents the dozens of dams that have been constructed across both shores of Long Island. You can see Beaver Lake Dam right there. That was where our study site was. This dam is located on the north shore of Long Island and is located in Nassau County. The second map right here represents alewife restoration efforts across Long Island. Wherever you see a fish symbol is where river herring have been spotted during previous spawning runs. The stars represent various restoration projects underway. So there's 53 projects in various stages of either planning, funding, or have been completely installed. The majority of these projects involve the bypass of a dam, either using a nature-like fishway or a technical fishway. So far, there have been 10 steep pass fishways and one nature-like fishway constructed or completely funded and will hopefully be constructed sometime this year or next year. There was one accidental dam removal due to Superstorm Sandy. The hurricane actually blew the dam out of the lake. So again, you can see Beaver Lake right there, located in Nassau County. Like I said before, we have only seen scarce observations of alewives in really low numbers at this lake. And the Beaver Lake fishway was installed in the fall of 2017. So this is our site, Beaver Lake in Milneck, New York. This map on the left right here is kind of a zoomed out view of our habitat. It might be hard to see in the back, but you have Beaver Brook right at the bottom left-hand corner of the map. It flows through Shoe Swamp Preserve into Beaver Lake through one outlet. Beaver Lake is located right here. It's a 24.4-hectare freshwater lake that's approximately 1 meter deep. This habitat is really important nursery and foraging habitat for multiple fish species throughout the year. In addition, dozens of eagles and bald eagles and osprey nest in the vicinity of Beaver Lake and rely on this habitat for as a source of food. Beaver Lake was created by a half-kilometer earthen dam labeled as a causeway in the picture on the right here. The Beaver Lake spillway is approximately 7 meters long and 2 meters high, preventing any fish from entering the lake. In the early 1990s, a local homeowner noticed that fish were getting stuck below the dam and were unable to pass into the lake, so we actually constructed a homemade fishway and installed it on the spillway. He really tried his best, but he had no knowledge of the many requirements for successful passage, so his fishway was basically ineffective in passing these fish. So then Beaver Lake flows over the spillway right here, under the causeway into Milneck Creek, which you can see right here in the map and also in the picture on the right. Milneck Creek is about 3 kilometers long. This is an extremely tidal brackish tributary. The mean tidal variation can vary a lot throughout Milneck Creek. So if you're at the spillway right here, it can be about 1.3 meters between high tide and low tide. But if you go further downstream, it can be up to 2.7 meters between high tide and low tide. Milneck Creek then flows out into Oyster Bay right here, which leads out to the Long Island Sound. So then, on the picture on the right, you see this channel right here. This is during high tide in Milneck Creek. The channel that you see is actually the freshwater output coming over the spillway. During low tide, Millnet Creek, the only source of water you have is this freshwater output. All the salt water is leaving this habitat. So this is the fishway that was completed in 2017. The Alaska Sea Pass was a project funded by the Long Island and Connecticut Nature Conservancies, funded by grants from the National Fish and Wildlife Foundation. These are pictures of different sections of our passage, of the fishway. So this is the exit pool right here. You can see the spillway in the background. This structure is about 4.25 meters in length. This is the sea pass section of the fishway right in the middle, about 9 meters in length, and this is the entrance structure located below the spillway in Millnet Creek, about 2.5 meters in length. So we have a couple different goals of this project. Our first goal was to monitor the efficacy of the new fishway installed at Beaver Lake. Since we don't have a spawning run returning every year, we translocated Alewife from the Conic River, represented by this redfish on the map right there, to Beaver Lake every year. The Conic River is one of the four main rivers on Long Island, and it has the second largest spawning run on Long Island. The run here is easy to catch, it's extremely predictable, and it always comes in at really large numbers. So in order to monitor the movement of translocated alewives, we use both pit tags and video to see if they can successfully use the passage. In addition, we wanted to test single-site fidelity within these species, so we monitored the return of translocated alewives back to the Conic River to see whether or not they could return. Our long-term goal with this project is to hopefully establish a spawning run within the lake. So first I'll go over the methods and results for monitoring the fishway, and then I'll go into the part of our project that discusses the returns. So like I said before, we translocated alewives from the Conic River out to Beaver Lake over the course of 4 years. The map on the left right here represents where we released all these fish. The different colored dots correspond to a different year. So in 2015 and 2016, we released fish below the Beaver Lake spillway in order to see if these fish were able to ascend the spillway and enter the lake prior to the installation of the new fishway. In 2017, in order to jumpstart a new population here, a new spawning population, we only released fish within Beaver Lake right here. Following in 2018, the first year following the installation of the fishway, we decided to again release alewives into the lake for the spawning population. We also released the new fish in front of the fishway entrance right here to monitor the fishway. We used two separate loop antennas during this project. The spillway antenna right here was obviously placed at the spillway. In 2015, the first year of operation, we actually tilted the spillway, the antenna over the spillway, so we could detect fish as they were attempting to ascend the spillway but were unable to enter the lake. The next 3 years, we actually tilted it back, like you can see in the picture right here, so it could only detect fish that were placed in the lake and leaving it or successfully getting into the lake, not just swimming up the spillway. In 2018, in order to monitor the fishway, we also constructed an entrance antenna, placed that inside of the entrance structure, so we could detect fish as they were attempting to use the fishway, but maybe not successfully passing through the entire structure. In addition to pit tag monitoring, we used an underwater camera within the exit pool of the fishway to monitor fish as they were going upstream and downstream. Our goal with this camera was to identify both tagged and untagged alewives swimming within the fishway to see if we possibly could find evidence of a natural spawning run at Millnet Creek. So these are results. Over the course of 4 years, we tagged and released a total of 548 alewives at Beaver Lake from the Conic River. In 2015, we detected two out of the 138 alewives released below the spillway by the spillway antenna. Both of these fish attempted to ascend the spillway multiple times over the course of the week throughout our monitoring period, which provided evidence that translocation might be an effective tool to monitor the efficacy of a new fishway at this habitat. In 2016, this was the first year that we changed we repositioned the spillway antenna so that way it was a little bit tilted more back. We did not detect any of the alewives released below the spillway entering the lake. However, this does not mean that they weren't attempting to swim up the spillway. We just weren't able to detect them entering the lake. In 2017, the first year we released fish directly into the lake, we detected 44% of these fish at the spillway antenna. These fish were detected about 5 days following the first release in 2017. The majority of these fish were detected multiple times over a time scale of up to like 3 weeks during the monitoring period. We detected these fish in schools of up to 11 fish at one time, which suggested to us that these fish were actually swimming in schools around Beaver Lake multiple times during the monitoring period. The number of fish that we detected, 44, represents the maximum number of fish that could have possibly left Beaver Lake following spawning. In 2018, we only detected 2 of the 50 fish that we released within the lake. We did not detect any of the fish released in front of the entrance at the spillway antenna. Again, we only used the entrance antenna in 2018 because that was the first season following the installation of the new fishway. We did not detect any of the fish that had been placed in the lake at this entrance antenna or detect any of the fish that were released in front of the fishway structure that year. We detected a total of 63 individuals using the fishway to swim both upstream and downstream into Beaver Lake. Unfortunately, due to the poor water quality at this habitat and high turbidity, we were unable to identify most of these fish down to the species level. We were unable to identify any tagged or untagged alewife using the passageway. However, we did have evidence of 9 common carp and 2 perch using the fishway to swim both upstream and downstream. We got detections from this camera during all tidal phases within Milnet Creek. This was really surprising because, like I mentioned before, the only source of water in Milnet Creek during an ebb tide is the flow of water coming from Beaver Lake. What we think happened is that these fish might have entered the fishway, the entrance structure, prior to the ebb tide. They may have actually gotten stuck and unable to leave the entrance structure since they couldn't swim over the top weir board. We think that they may have gotten overcrowded and actually swam up the fishway in order to avoid being so close to each other. 100% of the detections at this camera occurred during daylight.
It was working before.
So in this video, you're going to see 8 carp passing through past the camera. As you can see, the water quality is really poor. The viewport of this camera box is about 1/2 meter by 1/2 meter. So as you can see these fish passing, they're actually taking up the entire viewing, which suggests that these fish are at least 1/2 meter long, if not longer. So these were 8 common carp that we noticed. 8 was the highest number of fish that we had schooling within the fishway at one point. So this is a summary of our monitoring. In 2015, the detections of alewives attempting to ascend the spillway provided evidence that translocation might be an effective tool at this site to measure the efficacy of a new fishway. However, the first season following installation, we did not detect any fish attempting to enter the structure or pass through the structure. In addition, the exit pool monitor, the underwater camera didn't provide us any evidence of untagged alewives that we could identify using the fishway. However, we did notice that non-target species within the habitat are able to swim both upstream and downstream. For the releases into Beaver Lake, again, these represented the maximum number of fish that could have left the lake following spawning. In 2017, we had much higher numbers than 2018. We think that this most likely occurred because of the increased bird predation. As we were releasing fish in Beaver Lake the day in April, we noticed dozens of osprey basically circling the lake, waiting for us to just throw these fish in. The following weeks, as we would go to monitor equipment, we would also notice birds catching herring-like fish. So we think that the majority of these fish were probably just food. So now I'm going to go into monitoring the returns of translocated fish. Okay, back to Conic River. Okay, I might go a little bit faster. So these are 3 release sites, but Conic River was our one source site for this project. This is a loop antenna we used. We constructed in 2017 and 18. We placed it over the Nature Lake Fishway within Poughkeepsie River. So these are results for fish returning back to the original spawning habitat in 2017. We did not detect any of the fish returning from the Beaver Lake spillway release in 2015. However, we did detect 10% of the fish returning from the 2016 release. In 2018, we didn't detect any fish returning from 2015 or 2016. Below the spillway. However, we did detect fish returning from the 2017 releases at Beaver Lake and Swan Lake. The 3 fish released at Beaver Lake were fish we had placed within the lake. We had detected them at the spillway antenna, so this provided evidence that at least 3 fish are able to leave this habitat. We did not detect any fish returning from Twin Ponds from the release the previous year. In addition to these releases, we also detected fish returning from translocations that we did earlier on in April, which was really surprising. So we translocated these fish throughout April. The first detection we got was from Swan Lake. We estimated the most direct path these fish could have taken. So Swan Lake is about 62 kilometers away from the Conic River. So this fish swam about 5 kilometers a day to return in under 2 weeks. Next is Twin Ponds. This site is about 162 kilometers away from Conic River, so this fish swam approximately 7 kilometers a day. About a week later, we got another fish from Swan Lake. On May 1st, we got a fish returning from Beaver Lake. Beaver Lake is about 172 kilometers if this fish took a most direct path, which suggests that this fish swam an impressive 11 kilometers a day to return back to Conic River. So basically, we saw the Alewife can return back to original spawning habitat after being translocated to both shores of Long Island. They can return within the same or following year. We didn't detect any fish returning in subsequent seasons, most likely be due to the small number of Alewife that we have released at each site. So we think that a couple factors led to the low efficacy of the fishway the first season following installation. We think these fish underwent fallback due to stressors from being handled. There's a strong ebb tide. We had to release them during sub tide due to logistics. We think that as they underwent fallback and the strong ebb tide pushed them so far out of Milnet Creek that they were unable to find the entrance structure to the fishway. Our returns back to the Conic River also provide evidence that they do have a really strong homing drive to return back to familiar habitat. So what does this mean for translocation in general? So we think that translocation might be effective at Beaver Lake in initiating spawning run if we place them within the lake. We also think that this may be ineffective for monitoring the fishway. However, this was only the first season following installation, so we need to continue this. So like I said, I think we should continue this for at least 4 or 5 years because multiple studies have found that alewives can return on up to 10 years following the installation of a fishway. We think that it might be beneficial to release them at the start of a flood tide to give them more time within Milnet Creek. We're thinking of releasing as many fish as possible and earlier on during the season. Our Beaver Lake release was at the end of April, April 18th, which is considered to be close to the end of the spawning season for alewife within New York. We think that they were motivated to spawn in familiar habitat and immediately left Milnet Creek to return back to Conic River. We are thinking of cleaning the camera lens more often to hopefully improve the video quality to be able to identify fish as it passed through the exit pool. We're also thinking of constructing a baffle within the